expected.
I am without limit.
I must use this gift to protect others. Think you're so strong, try to withstand this!
Why can't they all be this easy?
More challenges lie ahead. I refuse to stop here.
Feels good to be so strong.
Oh. Maybe an 80 out of 100. Can't get any better than that. I'm a perfectionist. Shh. any better than that.
Sorry.
The more skillful I get, the more charming I become.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Long time no see. What's wrong? You look down.
Victor, it's you. What have you been doing this whole time?
I've been doing what I must.
Will you still be doing it for the foreseeable future?
Yes. To tell you the truth, I may never return from it.
You may be my rival, but I don't want to hold you back. So I won't stop you. But just don't forget that you're my rival. Got it?
Don't worry. I won't.
This necklace with the teardrop charm would suit Miki perfectly. And this grandiose ring just screams Fiore from all angles.
Hey, what are you looking at?
Accessories. Out of everything here, what do you think I should get, Fidel?
There's no question. The cat earrings, of course.
He likes the same things as me. I'm so happy.
Pardon me.
I learned something. I was told that when you're together with someone and it's fun, that's called being friends. Fidel, are you my friend?
Of course we're friends.
Mickey and Fiore, and Mr. Soldier, and Emerson and Anne, and you are all my friends. I'm so happy we can be together.
Whoops.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Miki, do you have a mom and a dad?
No, Relia. They both died years ago when I was very young. My father was a hunter, and very good with a bow, too. They tell me he knew all about animals and plants. He was also friends with Dr. Malir, who runs the infirmary.
Are you lonely without them?
No. I have Fidel now, so... Are you lonely, Relia?
No. I'm not lonely. I have you and everyone else.
That's great. Neither of us are lonely then.
I simply can't.
Come on. You know you want to.
They're military rules. I can't divulge them.
Just a few. You don't have to tell me every one.
I can't. Lieutenant, save me from this man. Please.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
You're such a good kid, Miki. Your parents must have poured their hearts out raising you.
No. Actually, they both passed away long ago. After that, Fiddly's parents took me in, raised me as if I were one of their own.
I see. So that's why you treat Fiddly like an older brother.
Is that how it looks?
What? You didn't realize that's how it came off? I've gotta say, that's a bit of a surprise.
I'm sorry. Old habits die hard, I guess. I should probably stop acting like that with him, right?
No, I'm almost positive he enjoys it. Lots of guys want little sisters. Don't stop. Keep it up.
Me? A little sister.
Relia?
Everyone's together, huh?
Lieutenant! Long time no see.
You look as good as always.
Lieutenant.
Hanna, Dax, Gunther, sorry to put you through all this trouble.
Come on, why you gotta be like that? You know Rasulia's safe in our hands.
I believe you mean it's safe in Dax's hands? Without all the intelligence he gathers, we'd be done for.
None of you have changed a bit.
Lieutenant, you're not leaving us again, are you?
Yes. My journey has yet to end.
I see.
Hanna, snap out of it. Don't worry. I'll pick up the lieutenant's slack while he's gone.
Lieutenant, leave Rasulia to us.
Thank you all. I am honored to have you in my unit.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Worried about something?
It's my subordinates. I left everything to them, but I don't know if they can handle it.
I understand how you feel.
Don't you ever get upset with Emerson for always leaving you to your own devices?
Not really. I take it as a sign of his trust in my abilities.
I never thought of it that way. I hope that's how they see this.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn. Sorry!
There was a dog over there. It was wagging its tail a lot.
Dogs wag their tails as a sign of goodwill. They're smart animals.
Goodwill? Like when they like you?
Yes.
If only you had a tail, Mr. Soldier, it'd be easier to understand you.
Ah, I see. decisive win with minimal casualties.
Now I can protect everyone. People to keep going to war. Everyone just wants to live in peace, yet time and time again.
It's often due to economic issues, that or ideological differences.
What if everyone in the world gets enough to eat? That might end war.
Curing hunger would help, but not solve the problem, since other desires motivate people too.
So feeding the world won't work? What a complicated issue. I'll have to cook up a more fitting solution eventually.
You, Assistant Number One. With this, I can finally complete my experiment. Yes, I've done it! I've proved the existence of alchemy! Huh? Did I scare you or something? Sorry about that. Wait, hear me out. I swear on my life I'm not lying. I raised a lot of money by claiming that I would make alchemy viable, but it didn't last. My research was really difficult, though. That part's the God's honest truth. At any rate, you saved my lab when I needed you the most. There's nothing like a skilled assistant when you're in a pinch. Yep, yep. Now, I can use my new alchemical technique to make mountains of gold!
success.
This is more fun than I expected. I'm finished.
What a masterpiece. What a masterpiece.
What is this?
I'd buy it.
Order up.
What craftsmanship?
How's this?
What is this?
It's everything I hoped for. And here we go.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Do you like sweet foods?
Do I ever? When I was a kid, my dream was to eat at least one of all the sweets in the world.
That's a rather, how do I say it, grandiose dream?
If only I had that transporter, I could eat any sweets I wanted.
The rules strictly prohibit using it like that.
Don't worry. If I ever really want to transport, I can always ask Relia to.
Calm down. You're not thinking straight.
Whoops.
Okay then, let's reconvene in front of the inn.
Emerson speaks very highly of you, Anne, especially your intelligence. Were you always so good at studying and such, even from a young age?
Of everyone I grew up with, I'd say my grandmother influenced me the most.
Your grandmother, you say?
Computers were her hobby, so when I was young, I would often play computer games or go on the internet with her.
Your grandmother sounds like an amazing woman. I'm so jealous of you.
Thank you. So, what are you planning on doing after this journey ends?
I want to teach the art of the sword.
Really? That sounds great.
I feel like that will allow Master Camus to live on. If I can impart to others the techniques he taught me, then he'll exist in the hearts of all who practice his fighting style.
That's just like you, Victor.
You're not going to laugh at me?
No, there's nothing to laugh at.
I'm such an idiot. I can't do anything right. What's this? Do I catch a whiff of a lady with a superior fashion sense? This shapely and amazingly dressed assistant number 3 makes an appearance. Take a gander at this accessory. Does it look like it's missing something to you?
Figured out how to improve it? That was quick! Wow, you want me to replace every single part? Oh, I spent 3 days and nights coming up with that design. All right, assistant number 1, you'll be responsible for provisioning us with the parts. I shouldn't even have to ask, though. Of course you'll do it for us, won't you, number 1?
If I get married, I hope it's to someone who enjoys whipping up tasty meals.
Huh, so you like the domestic type. Who knew?
Can you cook, Fiore?
I've been known to make a dish or two, but I won't cook for anyone other than my future husband.
Well, too bad for me. I am jealous of your husband-to-be, though.
Why not ask Miki, then? She's a great cook.
She's good, but her portions are a bit excessive.
decisive win was missed.
Why can't they all be this easy?
Hardly worth the effort.
This morning, I put my right foot on the ground first.
Is there something wrong with doing that?
I'll just go back to bed.
Are you crazy?
But if I don't put my left foot down first, I'll have bad luck all day.
Do what you want, then.
Challenges lie ahead.
Close to perfect as it gets.
We'll be right back.
see you're ogling the women like you always do.
I don't have much choice in the matter. In outer space, it's a crime.
Close ready! People let you get away!
A decisive win with minimal casualties.
Good to go.
Everybody,
you think you're so strong? Try to withstand this.
What can I say? I'm a perfectionist. The more skillful I get, the more charming I become.
Without limits.
Let's meet at the training hall.
Hehehe.
You really enjoy using that machine, don't you, Anne?
It's that easy to tell?
Well, you do use it all the time.
And you? How do you feel about using swords?
I practice swordsmanship because it's necessary.
You're saying it's nothing more than a job to you?
Yeah, to be honest, I don't even like going into battle.
I see.
Sorry.
Now I remember that I have a big sister, too. The two of us. We were always together back at the laboratory. But we had no freedom. None at all. I was lucky and got away from there. I'm free, but my sister, she's still trapped. They're not going to let her go. I want to tell my sister about so many things. Like about how big the outside world is, and all the wonderful things that go on in it.
Riddle me this. When you clasp your hands in front of your chest, which of your thumbs goes on top of the other? The left one or the right?
I'm almost positive I put my right thumb on top.
Ha ha! Of course it's your right hand. I just knew it.
What's this for, anyway?
People whose right hands go on top are said to think with their left brain, while those whose left hands go on top are supposedly right brain.
What are these left brains and right brains you speak of? I don't get it.
I knew it. Knew it'd be the right hand.
That's great, but how about letting me know what you're talking about?
Something is thirsting for blood. There it is.
What's wrong?
Come get some!
What are you doing, Victor? It's just a cat!
Don't stop me, Miki. This is something I have to do for myself.
Oh, wait. Are you afraid of cats?
I'll let it slide for today. Count yourself lucky, cat.
You sound exactly like a sore loser.
must use this gift to protect others.
Let's meet at the training hall. Anne, you and Emerson are really something else. Just seeing how decisive and serious you are on your ship, it sent chills down my spine.
Thank you. Say, Fidel, would you like to join the military too?
Yes, I would. It'd be an honor to follow in my father's footsteps.
You would be more than welcome. And I'm not talking about Rasulia's military. You should join ours. Once all this is over, I'll ask Captain Kenny if you can come to Earth with us.
I don't like the looks of this.
His skills are impressive. I wonder if he'd accept an offer to fight.
Victor, he's an old man. What are you talking about?
Please, don't be ridiculous, Miki. He's clearly the master of something.
Well, he looks like an ordinary old man to me. I think he might be deaf. I knew it. He's just an ordinary old guy.
So he thinks I'm not even worth glancing at, does he? Then I'll show him by training even harder.
What the?